Welcome to the Marshal Update. Today is March 29th and it is an A Day. We are your hosts. I'm Naomi and this is Jake.
Thanks for all those who came to prom. It was truly out of this world.
Congratulations to our prom royalty. As prom king, Jake Meese, Queen Malia Sellers, Prince Isaiah Gale, Princess Amory Swift, and Duchess Dakota Dippo.
Marshal Madness has been happening all this week, so come to the gym today to find out who's going to win in that championship game.
Do you like to make videos? Now is your chance to enter the Marshal Update Film Festival. The theme is Marshal Pride.
Create a short film, three to five minutes long, describing what your Marshal Pride means to you. Submit it at rockwelljournalism@gmail.com by May 1st. Cash prizes will be awarded for each category.
Let's get to our first segment, Keeping It Real with Coach Parker.
The word this week is class. And if the adjectives or verbs in front of it or pronouns, I don't know, I never get things right. But stay goes stay in class. I promise you, if you stay in class, you will never fail. I promise you there will not be a teacher at this institution that will fail you if you come to class every day on time and stay there. They will not fail you. That's my promise from the old man to you kids.
This week in Senior Moments with yours truly was with Braden Blumel. I had a great conversation. Let's check it out.
This is Senior Moments with Jake Meese. This is what I do. I interview seniors and I meet people and I love them. Oh, hi. Senior Moments.
Hello, welcome to Senior Moments with Jake Meese. Here I have Braden Blumel. Braden, how are you?
I'm pretty good. How about you, Meese?
That's pretty good. I'm doing swell myself. You know how this goes. I'm just going to ask you two simple questions. First, what was your favorite memory at Rockwell?
Being challenged to run for student government, because I had friends who thought I wouldn't actually run, and I decided to run because I'm crazy.
You are pretty crazy, Braden. I do love student government. It's a good time. Good memories. Second question, what's your some senior advice you have for the young viewers out there?
I would suggest doing things that you're scared to do, like trying things that you wouldn't normally try, because, I mean, you're young. Live while you can.
Live while we're young. By One Direction. Basically what he's saying. Thank you, Braden. It's been a good time, big guy. Get it?
Got it.
Good.
For this week's question of the week, we asked students and staff about their worst vacation ever. Let's see what they had to say.
Yeah, one time I went to Florida, bro, and I almost stepped on a poisonous fish, threw it, and then he ran back and he was like, yo, let me see that, and he chased me down the beach with it.
Worst vacation ever would probably be my vacation down in St. George, where the third day down there, I broke my phone on accident.
Okay, so I went to California and I was 8 years old and I was trick-or-treating in the ghetto and there was this car driving super slow by us. So I started running and I fell on my face and dropped all of my candy and it was a really bad night.
Okay, my worst vacation is back when I was in elementary school, we had one of those Thanksgiving feasts for the day, and a parent sent something, and it gave a lot of us kids food poisoning. So we were driving to my grandmother's house, which was 6 hours away, and I was really sick on the side of the road. And we're going down the freeway, and I'm like, Mom, I've got to throw up. I've got to throw up. Pull over, pull over. And she said, no, just throw up into the bag. So I grab a paper McDonald's sack and threw up. And what happens with paper and water? Then we had a dog in the back seat of the car who also was sick the whole way there, and he crapped everywhere all over this blanket, and the smell was so gross. So my mom did something she would never ever do, and she pulled over the side of the road and she just threw the blanket out on the side of the road and we just left. So that was my worst vacation ever.
I went to Vegas and my mom's friend little girl came with us, and so she was like really annoying, so I hated that trip, but yeah.
One time driving back from Idaho with my family, about probably 10 miles from the Utah-Idaho border where there is absolutely nothing, we lost a tire and it rolled out across the road in front of us, and we were stuck on the side of the road for 4.5 hours before a tow truck was able to come and pick us up. And then we had to go to the nearby town and stay a night in a motel while my dad rode his bike to the nearest city to be able to replace our tire on our car before we could get home.
Drama team who won second place overall in their competition a couple weeks ago. Several students also won awards in their individual events. They head to state on April 13th. Here's Sam Lofgren to give us a scoop on what happened.
So at Region this year, then I got second place dramatic monologues, and the team overall got second place sweepstakes, which isn't as good as we wanted to do, but it's about where we thought we would be, which is good. And we got second place one act, which is, again, not where we wanted to be, but it's still really good. For state, then we're preparing and we're working extra hard so that we can all get first place for our one act and for sweepstakes, and fingers crossed, this time we get everyone placing. That would be pretty cool.
Ethan Barrett has been working hard to recreate some of our favorite vines, so let's check them out.
This one's to end racism.
I spilled lipstick in your Valentino bag.
Oh, you spilled lipstick in my Valentino bag!
Walk, guacamole, walk, guacamole, walk, guacamole.
This week's Teacher of the Week is Mr. Young. Let's get to know him better. How long have you worked at Warrockville?
I've worked here since we opened. 11 years, whatever it is.
How did you find out about Rockwell?
So I actually found out about it through a job. It's not supposed to look at the camera, so. I like looking at you. I was making video games for Nintendo, and the studio that I was working for, they're making a few bad decisions, and so I kind of felt like, yeah, they're gonna probably have problems, and so I started networking with some people, and they mentioned a school opening up in Eagle Mountain. I'm like, sweet, that's like right down my house, so I'm stoked. And so anyways, came, I interviewed, and the best part about that interview, I mean, you know, because I interviewed with Darren Beck and the old business manager years ago, Virginia Bowser. You guys probably don't even know her. I remember during the interview, they asked me, so like PC or Mac? And I'm like a PC guy, and I was like, PC. And then like, I don't know, like a week after the interview, whatever, I came in to do paperwork or something, and I saw all these Macs rolling off the back of a FedEx truck. I'm like, what the hell? Why even ask me if it's freaking PCs or if you're gonna bring in a bunch of damn Apples, man? I was like, what? But I remember that and laughed. I was like, okay, yeah. So that's how I learned about it, basically, just through networking. And I saw, and then Beck, I was like, it was after my interview, how they do like those city parade things every summer, right? Mm-hmm. So Saratoga Springs did the city parade, but they used to do it like in my neighborhood before they did it like in the main, like by Westlake. And so like we didn't even know about it, like, because we just moved here, and we were paying attention or whatever. And like all of a sudden this little parade's coming down our street, like near our street. I'm like, what the hell? And I look, and like as all these things are going by, there's like Darren Beck walking with like a few of the other, Candace I think was with him, and a few other people, and like, and I was like, hey, I know that guy. Yeah, that was funny. And I was like, hey, did you read my, that was right after I applied. And I was like, hey, did you go through my application yet? And he's like, yeah, I sent you an email. So yeah, that's funny. That was...
When did you decide to become a teacher?
So I taught art classes while I was still making games. I just kind of did it on the side because someone asked me. I kind of got roped into it, honestly. Like, one of my buddies was the teacher, and he was like his wife's having a baby or something. He said, hey, can you teach for a couple weeks? And so I went and I taught for a couple weeks for him, just kind of subbed for him. And, then they like, oh, you should come here and teach. And so anyway, so I got my teaching degree or my credential in California, and I taught at a junior college. It was really weird because when I got there, like, I don't know, maybe I pissed everybody off, but like the entire like art department just quit. Like right when I got there, like I was like, hey, what's up? They're like, oh, F you, dude, I'm out. And I'm like, the hell, you know? And so I was like the only person teaching. And so, and they had taken the curriculum with them, and so I had to make up my whole curriculum and do everything. And so I taught for a year. And then I understood after that year, I realized why they quit, because the job sucked, you know? And so then I left, and then I just made games or whatever, moved here, continued to make games. But I already have my license, and so when that job came up, mm-hmm. when I found out about it, I was like, well, I already have my license, so I might as well just teach. How hard can high school be? That was a stupid thing to say. High school is hella hard compared to teaching college. So different. I mean, because you got to deal with parents.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Cool.
Now let's go to our current events with Jaden and Cody.
Welcome to current events, Marshals.
India has shot down a weather satellite and declared themselves a space power, making them the fourth nation to be able to flex that they shot down a satellite.
The fastest flowing Greenland glacier has abruptly slowed its melting rate. It's been the fastest flowing and thinning glacier on the vast ice island for the past 20 years. It has temporarily slowed its retreat and has thickened in the past few years.
Let's learn some new dance moves this week in Isaac's Dance School.
Okay, we have a lot going on in sports this week. Let's check it out with Chandler and Micah.
I'm here with Renell, the coach of our track team here at Rockwell. Renell, what are you most excited about this season?
That's a tough one. There's so many things to be excited about with our runners. We've got some amazing runners. But I think this season is pretty exciting because we're finally going to be able to get our track put in. So they'll be breaking ground on the 29th. To get our track in, and that'll make it much easier to train.
Yeah, I'm like the best runner on that team, don't you think? Just kidding. What made you want to coach track in the first place?
I love running. I love running, and I love youth. I love dealing with teenagers, which a lot of adults don't, but I actually love dealing with teenagers, and runners are just generally good kids. And
is it hard to deal with Marshall on a daily basis?
On a daily basis, it can be hard to deal with Marshall, yes. But for the most part, he's a good kid, too. All
right. Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Coach Griffiths and a couple of her players. How's your season going so far this year?
Good.
It's great.
Good.
Okay. And when's your next game?
Today.
Today.
Today in Fillmore.
And the one after that is next Tuesday, right?
Yep. Next Tuesday.
All right. And is there anything that you guys think that you should work on?
I think we need to get into the batting cages a little bit more, practice hitting, but we're doing pretty good so far.
I think the grounders we need to work on a little.
Catching grounders.
A lot of it is overthrows because they tend to overthrow a lot.
Yeah.
And they practice every week, so they're bound to get better. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Squad Hall!
Six, seven, eight.
what you call an icon living. Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Nylon cover 5 minutes. Whoa, we are too hot in the business. About to make a movie independent. Need new trucks independent. I need you to listen to the vision. All your verses sound like dirty dishes. I'm about to clean them in the kitchen. And we making money by the minute. I'm about to do a way different. I am just an icon living.
I am just an icon living. Icon living. I am just an icon living. Living. I am just an icon living.
I am not a Mayan, I'm a menace. It's wild, you can lie like a professor. I don't got the time to put you on a stretcher. I am here and I still flex. I am just an icon living. Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Whoa, I'm high style, cover 5 minutes. Whoa, we are so hot in the business. Last verse was before the award show.
What?
Icon tatted on my torso. Me and Moy dipping in the porso. What? I ain't even taking on torso. What? Damn. Last girl signed a divorce, so what? Now I'm focused and we about to all blow up. We just tryna make the whole crowd go nuts. What? Look, we don't know no one like you. Gold grills and you dance like Michael. No eyes, misfits, no typos. Look, wait, we just wanna make you go psycho. Put $100,000 in the Bible. I took the game with my eyes closed. Last verse was before the award show. Icon tatted on my torso. Me and Moy dipping in the porso. What? I ain't even taking on torso. What? Your shit is fire, I'm more so. What? Young Jaden dying on the floor. So what? She broke my heart.
Thanks, Marshals, and have a stupendous day.